essence of a violet color, who are allied to man, esoteric body, and who transmit Earth's prana, or the prana of whichever planet man may be functioning upon during a physical incarnation. Every pertinent question might here be asked, and though we may not fully explain the mystery, a few. Sug. THETHERICYANAPRANA 93. Just if hints may be possible, we might ask, what causes the apparent deadness of the moon? Could there be the life upon it? Does solar prana have no effect there? What constitutes the difference between the apparently dead moon and a live planet, such as the Earth? 40. Upon a hidden mystery, of which the solution lies revealed for those who seek, in the fact that human beings and certain groups of devas are no longer found upon the moon. Man has not ceased to exist upon the moon because it is dead and cannot therefore support his life, but the moon is dead because man and these deva groups have been removed from off its surface and from its sphere of influence. Poor man and the devas act on every planet as intermediaries or as transmitting agencies. Where they are not found, then certain great activities become impossible, and disintegration sets in. The reason for this removal lies in the cosmic law of cause and effect, our cosmic karma, and in the composite, yet individual, history is that one of the heavenly men whose body, compared to any other dead planet at any time happened to be. 3. The prana of forms. It must first be pointed out that forms are necessarily of two kinds, each having a different place in the scheme. Forms that are the result of the work of the third and the second logos, and their united life. Such forms are the units in the vegetable, animal and mineral kingdoms. Forms that are the result of the united action of the three logos, and comprise the strictly viva and human forms. There is also the still simpler form embodied in the substance of which all the other forms are made. This man, 40S, P.I. 170 to 180. 41S. P.I. 179. Chart 2 is on page 94. THETHERICYANAPRANA 95. Tear is strictly speaking the atomic and molecular matter, and is animated by the life or energy of the third logos. In dealing with the first group of forms, it must be noted that the pranic emanations given off by units of the animal and vegetable kingdom after they have absorbed both solar and planetary prana are naturally a combination of the two, and are transmitted by means of surface radiation, as in solar and planetary prana. Groups of devas of a not very high order, who have a curious and intricate relationship to the group soul of the radiating animal or vegetable. This matter cannot be dealt with here. These devas are also of a violet. A few, but of such a pale color as to be almost gray, they are in a transitional state, and merge with a puzzling confusion with groups of entities that are almost on the involutionary arc. 42 involutionary arc is the term applied to the first part of the evolutionary process. It covers the path of descent, or the coming down of spirit into ever denser matter until the lowest point is reached, the point of densest concretion. The latter half of the process is called evolutionary and marks the ascent or return of spirit to its emanating source, plus the gains of the evolutionary process. 43 inches with 30 root corings. In the diagram, the symbols of the three aspects of the logos are placed outside of time and space, and only the streams of influence from them descend into our system of planes. They represent in due order what are commonly called the three persons of the Trinity. It will be seen that from each of them an outpouring of life or force is projected into the planes below. The first of these in order is the straight line which descends from the third aspect. The second is that part of the large oval which lies on our left hand, the stream which descends from the second aspect until it has touched the lowest point in matter, and then rises again up the side on our right hand until it reaches the lower mental level. It will be noted that in both of these outpourings the divine life becomes darker and more veiled as it descends into matter, until at the lowest point we might almost fail to recognize it as divine life at all, but as it rises again when it has passed its nadir, it shows itself somewhat more clearly. The third outpouring which descends from the highest aspect of the logos differs from the others in that it is in no way clouded by the matter through which it passes, but retains its virgin purity and splendor untarnished. It will be noted that this outpouring descends only to the level of the Buddhic plane, the fourth plane, and that the link between the two is formed by a triangle in a circle, representing the individual soul of man, the reincarnating ego. Here the triangle is contributed by the third outpouring and the circle by the second. The Christian